Good evening to all of you. So today is my week second, and today we are going to discuss chapter number one. And as I told you, I just in my face-to-face class, so today we are discussing the foundations, logics, and proof. These things we will discuss today. So before discussing that, can you raise your voice? Okay, please wait a minute. So now tell me, can you hear me clearly or not? So hopefully you can listen me clearly. Okay, so I like. So let me proceed. First of all, I've listened that there are some students, they are asking that regarding the assignment and regarding the folders. So today I create some folders, but till now there is no any assignments. The assignment will be given to you after the week third. The first assignment I will give you. So I just create the folder, and after third week I will put the assignment on that particular folder. So it's the empty folder right now, and there are the one more folder there is edit, that is called the even solution of the books. Yani you can find the even solution of the books. Odd solution you have to do yourself, and even solution I give you. These are the from the books, so you can select, you can collect the files from that folder. And also you can download the PowerPoint slides that I teach you today. These PowerPoint slides you can download from the PowerPoint slides folder. I think all of you know, are aware about that, how you can access the extra resources folder. If you don't know this, I will tell you at the end of my lecture. I will tell you how you can operate, how you can handle the folder, how you can download the PowerPoint slides from that folder. So now let's start our chapter, that is the foundation of logic and proofs. Here we will discuss, first of all we will discuss the propositions. And after that, we are going to discuss the connectiveness, meaning is that the first of all, we will discuss what is the negation. Negation means we are going to discuss the negation. The symbol of negation is like this. This is the symbol of negation. We will discuss this symbol negation. After that, we will discuss the conjunction. The symbol of conjunction is like this. And after that, we will discuss the disjunction. Disjunction. The symbol of disjunction is like this. Meaning that it is or. Sometimes we say that it is or. And the next thing we will discuss, that is the implication. Implication, the symbol of implication is like this. And after that we will discuss the biconditional statement. Yani, or we can say that it is if and only if. This is the these are the these are the we will discuss these things in our today's lecture. So first of all we will discuss these things. After that we are I will tell you what are the uses in the trust table. After that we will see how we can make the trust table as a combined statement. If we have a combined statement, how we can do the combined statement with the help of these five things. So now let's proceed. First of all we will discuss a proposition. The definition of proposition is says that a proposition is a declarative sentence that is either true or false. Whenever we say that a statement that is either true or false, that is called a proposition. So these are the examples of the propositions. It says that the first example is say that moon is made of green cheese. So this statement is either true or false. So this statement is false. So it means this is a proposition. And similarly, the second thing is I'm repeating the same lecture as I told you in my face-to-face class. In my, whatever I teach you in my face-to-face class here, I'm repeating, and that's in the PowerPoint slides. So if you have, so that you can understand clearly, and so that you can got you have a clear concept with the PowerPoint slides. So that I'm going to repeat that thing again. So the next thing is Toronto is the capital of New Jersey. So whether this statement is true or false, so it is again the proposition. So Toronto is the capital of Canada. Again, this statement is true or false. So this is a proposition. Next thing is 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Again, this statement is true or false. So this, it means it is a proposition. This is a true. Again, if we say that 0 plus 0 will be is equal to 2. So this statement is false. So this is again a proposition. So according to the definition, it says that either the statement is true or false, we say that it is a proposition. Now, there are some more examples are there. Here it says that if the statement says that sit down. So from this statement, we are not going to conclude anything. It says that just sit down. So it means that it is not a proposition. Similarly, if someone asks the question, what time it is? So from this statement also, we are not getting any good, any true or false. So we say that yes, it is also not a proposition. So if someone says that x plus 1 is equal to 2, so it is also not proposition. And someone says that x plus y is equal to z, it is also not a proposition, because of we have so many values of x and we have so many values of y. So that it is not a proposition. We are not telling that whether this statement is true or false. If we change different values of x, we got different answer. So that's why it is not a proposition. Next. Now we come to our propositional variables. So we have the propositional variables. Most of the time we use the propositional variables are P, Q, R, S. In this, we are using P, Q, R, S are the propositional variables. So, or you can use any other variable like A, B, C, D, E, any variable you can use. But most of the time, we are using P, Q, R, S are the propositional variables. So there are the five things, as I told you in my face-to-face class. There are the five things. The first thing is the negation. The symbol of the negation is represented by like this. And the second thing you will remember that is called the conjunction, or we can say that it is a and. The symbol of conjunction is denoted by like this. And the third thing is disjunction. The disjunction is denoted by like or. And the fourth thing is like a implication. Implication is an arrow. And the last thing is called the biconditional statement, meaning double arrow on the both sides. That is called the biconditional statement. So we will discuss one by one these five things in a truth table. So let us see. So the first, the truth table of the negation is, what is the truth table of the negation? So if let us first of all, we have a proposition P. And the negation of P denoted by like this. This is the symbol of the negation. This is the symbol of the negation. So if we have a P, then the negation of P is denoted by like this. So if we have a P is true, then the negation of P is called false. So if P is false, then the negation of P is true. And it is just opposite of the thing. Whatever, if it is true, then the negation will be false. If it is false, the negation will be true. So these are the examples of the negation. Now let's move further. The second thing is called a conjunction. So the conjunction is a proposition P and Q, and it is denoted by P and Q. We say that it is P and Q. So, or we can say that the conjunction of P and Q. So there are the four things we can say that it is true, true, false, false. Let us we assume the four points of P and the four points of Q, true, false, true, false. So now the conjunction of P and Q will be true and true will be true. And false will be false. False and true will be false. False and false will be false. So this table, you have to memorize this table because of we have to use this table in after when we are going to discuss the compound statements. These tables are very helpful there because of if we don't know what are the in conjunction, what are the disjunction, we are if we don't know the basic concepts of the table, then we cannot solve the compound statements. So you have to memorize all these five results that I'm going to teach you. So the second thing is conjunction. So hopefully you remember these points, the conjunction. Now the third thing that we are going to discuss, that is called the disjunction. So this is called the disjunction. So the distinction of the proposition P and Q is denoted by P or Q, and it has the truth table of this like this. So if we have P and Q, there are any true or true will be true. This is the truth table of the distinction. Similarly, true or false will be is equal to true. False or true will be is equal to true. False or false will be is equal to false. So this is the table of the disjunction. So this is the third table that we are going to discuss. As I told you, there are the five points are there. So this is the third point. So this table also you have to memorize. Now the next thing, the fourth thing is that is called the implication. The implication, if P and Q are the propositions, then P implies Q. It is called the implication or implies Q. Or we can say that it is a conditional statement, or we can say that it is the implication. So which is read as if P then Q and has a truth table. So the truth table of if P then Q is true implies true will be is equal to true. True implies false will be equal to false. And false implies true will be is equal to true. And false implies false will be is equal to true. So this is the implication table, truth table of this. So this is called a truth table of implication. Or we can say that it is if then P. And if there are so many words, you can say that either you can say that it is a conditional statement, or you can say that it is an implication, or you can say that if P then Q. So there are so many words, you can say whatever you want, you can say anything. Or like this, you can say that here I'm going to in detail I tell you, either you can say that if P then Q, it is right. If you say that if P Q, it is true. Q unless not P, Q if P, Q whenever P, Q follows from P, P implies Q, P only if Q, Q when P, Q when P, P is sufficient for Q, Q is necessary for P. So in necessary condition P is Q, a sufficient condition Q is P. So there are so many types wherever you want, you can say these things. But most commonly we can say that if P then Q, this is the most common that we are using, or we can say that it's implied. So and the last thing that we are going to discuss that is called the biconditional statement. So biconditional statements say that if we have a proposition that's P if and only if Q. So any if we have a double arrow on the both side arrow, then we say that it is a biconditional statement. So or we can say that it is P if and only if Q. Any or in a, as I told you in my previous class, we can write if and only if. We can write double if, I double F. This is called if and only if. Or we can say it is a biconditional statement, or it is if and only if. So the first table of the if and only if is true and true will be true, true false will be false, true false true will be false, and false false will be true. This is the biconditional statement. So till now we complete all the 5 points. So hopefully you understand all these 5 points. If you have any confusion, you can ask me. Yes, if and this is the biconditional statement, this is called the biconditional statement, and it has both side arrow, on the left side as well as on the right side, both the side arrows is there. So we say that it is a biconditional statement, or we can say that it is if and only if Q. So, or we can define like double F, I double F, if this is also we can define if and only if. And the table of this if and only if is the table, trust table of this is T, true become true, and true false become false, false true become false, and false false become true. So, another example it says that if P denotes I am at home and Q denotes it's raining, then if P then Q. If and only if P then Q denotes I am at home, if and only if it is rainy. So the condition is like this: I am at home if and only if it is rainy. So now there are some compound statements that we are going to discuss. So these are the 5 points. So keep in mind these 5 points. After that, we are going to discuss the compound statement with the help of these 5 points. So let's proceed. Dear Ahmed, it is good if you understand the concept behind this, how we can, the concept of if and only if, the concept of and, the concept of not. If you understand it, then there is no need to memorize. If you don't understand, then you have to memorize it. It's up to you. So it's my suggestion, just try to understand that how we can, how it's going on. So just understand this, so that there is no need to memorize it. So now we are going to discuss, this is a compound statement, and we have to draw the truth table of this compound statement. So if you remember in my face-to-face class, I told you that whenever we have a compound statement, we will apply, first we will apply the negation sign. First of all, we will apply the negation sign. After that, we will apply the and, then or, then implies, then if and only if. In this way, we will proceed. From left to right, we will proceed. So same here, we will do that. First of all, I will apply the op I will find what is negation of R. After that we will find P and Q, P or Q. After that, and the last we will apply if then Q. So let us see. There are the three variables here. Someone asked the question, we have the two variables. So in this question there are the three variables P, Q, R. So you, it's up to you how many variables you can take. It's up to you. As many as variable, there are the lots of problems. It is a big problem. So if you take the two variables P and Q, then there are only the four possibilities, like true, true, false, false. If you take the three variables, then there are how many, like two, there are the eight possibilities are there. If you take the three variables, there are the eight possibilities are there. So it's up to you how many variables you can take. So here we are taking the three variables P, Q and R. So let us see what will be the compound statements. So the compound statements will be, what first of all we will find what is not R. So not R means we have this R. So not means true become false, false become true, true become false, false become true, and true become false, false become true, true become false, false become true. After that we find P or Q. So P or Q means true, true or true will be true, and true or true will be true again, true or false will be true, true or false will be true again, and false or true will be true, and false or true will be true, and similarly false and false. In this way we can find. Now lastly we will apply the imply statement, if P then Q. So any, yeah, we apply P or Q imply not R, meaning is that we will apply true imply false will be is equal to false, true imply true will be is equal to true, true imply false will be is equal to false, true imply true will be is equal to true, and true imply false will be is equal to false. In this way, true, 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 in this way we can find the compound statements. Now, next, so do you have any query? Yes, Mr. Anas, if you have any ask question, then ask me. You can write, it's good, you can write whatever you have problem, otherwise we will discuss at the end of the lecture. If you have in the same slide, if you have a problem, then you can discuss me, otherwise in the end we can discuss. So let's proceed further. There are some more examples are there, and this the questions is like, there are some more compound statements are there, you will see at your home. These are the compound statements and how we can solve these, you can see at your home. So here, precedence logical operators are given, that I told you just before, 5 minutes before I told you. So in this way we will proceed. First of all we will operate the negation, then AND, then OR, then imply, then IF and ONLY. In this way we will proceed, we will go to proceed further. So the next thing is, the next topic is, what are the tautology and what are the contradictions. So the definition of tautology says that a tautology is a proposition which is always true. So it is called the tautology. Whenever our statement is true, we say that it is a tautology. And the definition of the contradiction is, whenever our statement is false, we say that it is a contradiction. And the third thing is contingency. So we say that when our statement is, we say that it is neither tautology or not contradiction, we say that it is a contingency. So in this way we can say that it is a tautology, contradiction and contingency. So these are the three things are there. So let us take an example. I will show you. So we have a P and this is, we have a not P. So if we combine with or, we say that it is P or not P. So yani false or true, true or false will be true, and false or true will be true. So all the things in this column are true. So we say that this is a tautology. And what about this, if we say that P and not P, yani true and false will be false, false and true will be false. So we say that all the statement in this column are false. So we say that it is a contradiction because of all the statements are false. So it is a contradiction. So hopefully you understand the concepts between the, hopefully you understand the concepts between the tautology and contradiction. Whenever our statement is true, we say that it is a tautology, and whenever our statement is false, we say that it is a contradiction. So let's proceed. So here the question says that equivalent, yes, the question says that show that there, these are the two statements and both of them are equal. You have to show these two things. So as usual we have to draw the first we draw the P, second we draw Q, and then we will draw the not P. We will rewrite the not P, and after that we will write the not P or Q. So we write not P or Q. Means is that any false or true will be true, false or false will be false, true or true will be true, and true or false will be true. And after that we know that this is the P implied Q statement. We know this because of from the five tables we know. So now after that we compare this, all the things in this column are same as all the things in this column. So it means that these are two equivalent, not P or Q, and P implies Q, both the things are same. So in this way we can see this. Now there are some laws are there, some algebraic laws are there that are useful for us. So these laws are called, some laws are called like De Morgan's law, and some more laws we will discuss, like a commutative law, like a associative law. So these laws are from algebra. Hopefully you are reading these laws in your previous classes, like a absorption law, commutative law, associative law, De Morgan's law. These are the laws of the mathematics, and you read in your previous classes. So these are the laws are there. You will read these laws. So now these are the commutative law, associative law, distributive law, absorption law. Any commutative law this like this, if we are just interchange this, any P and Q will be equal to Q and P, and P or and Q will be equal to Q and P. Associative law is if we interchange, if we change the bracket from here to here, there is no change. So similarly distributive law, left hand distributive law, right hand distributive law, absorption law. Now, next is there is a problem based on Lee's law that we are going to discuss. So this is a problem, and it says that show that not P or not P and Q is logically equivalent to this. We have to show by the laws. So we are going to show this. This question is on the assignment on the last semester. So it says that not P or not P and Q. So what we did, first of all, we will insert not in inside the bracket. So when we are going to insert not P inside the bracket, so what it will be? It will be the or become and, the or become and it will be equal to not P and this will not inside, and the rest of the things are same. So this is called the second De Morgan's law. We have to write this here. Again, what I did, I will again insert this not into inside the bracket. So what it will be happen, so not P and not P and not Q. We are going to insert not inside the bracket. So this is called the first De Morgan's law. After that, we are again, if we see not and not become simply P. Yani cancel out not to not become, yes. So simply P and rest of the things are same. There is no any change. So it says that double negation law. Yani not to not cancel out. Similarly, the next thing is what we did, we can write, we can open the bracket like this with not P and P and not P or not Q. We can open the bracket. So we just open the bracket, we say that it is called the second distributive law. After that, we assume this one is a F. Let us, we assume whole this is F. We assume that it is F. And it will be or, the rest of the thing are same. So we interchange F from here to here on the left side. We are, it is on the left side, now we are coming on the right side. So we say that it is by the commutative law for distinction. Now after that, it, we can write it like a P and not Q by the identity law of F. So this, these things we have to write on the right side. So this is the important, that we have to write every step on the right side. So this question is on the assignment on the last semester. So next thing is, so similarly, one more example is there, you will see at your home how we can solve. So it is the end of today's lecture. Now there is a little bit of revision that we are going to take. So just for your understanding, I just take the revision for the 5 minutes. So first of all, I take what I discuss, what are the propositions. So these are the propositions. Canada is, Toronto is the capital of Canada. Yes, it is a proposition. It is not the proposition. It is the proposition, it is not the proposition, it is not the proposition. So these are the variables of the proposition. After that, I discuss there are some negation and some several things we are going to discuss. 5 points we discuss negation and or imply if and only. So these are the truth tables that we discuss, and after that we discuss the conjunction and then disjunctions. We discuss what are the conjunctions are there, what are the disjunctions are there, and then we will discuss the truth table of these compound statements. What are the truth table of the and, what are the truth table of or. These things we will discuss, and after that we discuss the conditional statement P implying Q, and there are certain examples are there. These are very helpful for you when you read it at your home. So these are more examples are there. And this is the biconditional statement, yani if and only if, double if. So this is the biconditional statement, and it's denoted by the double arrow. So this is the first table of the biconditional statement, and these are the some compound statements are there. How we can draw the first table of these compound statements, you will read at your home, because I already discussed these things in the previous slides. So you will read it carefully, and there are some the precedence of the logical operators are there. In this manner, in this way, we will read these things, and there are some more examples are there, and there is a bitwise operations like OR and XOR. So bitwise operations, if we are going to add 0 or 1 will be equal to 1, 1 or 0 will be 1, 1 or 1 will be 1, 1 or 0 will be 1. Similarly, 0 and 1 will be 0, 1 and 0 will be 0, 1 and 1 will be 1, and 1 and 0 will be 1. In this way we can read. So there are some more, the tautology, lastly we discussed the tautology, and the contradictions are there. So these are things we discussed. And next thing is what are the not P or not Q. The XOR is a combination of the two things. You can read there already. You can read it. There are the main 5 points are there, as I told you. XOR is a combination of two things. There is nothing new in the XOR, so that's why I'm not expecting to this. So lastly we discussed there are some logical equivalences are there, and how we can prove this with the help of these things by laws. So we discussed these things. This is the end of today's lecture. So now if you have any questions, you can ask me. Yeah, you can ask me, yes, Anas, you can ask me what's your problem. Okay, you can say that we can come back on the if and only if slides. Oh, you mean to say that I'll come on the if and only if slide. So let us we come back on the if and only if slides if you have a problem on that particular slide. It is a biconditional statement, and it is if and only. So hopefully, just now tell me what is the problem in this slide. This is a biconditional statement, and it says that if and only. I'm going to hopefully I'm repeating once again. I'm going to share some of the PowerPoint slides on the Blackboard. I create a folder on the extra resources. You can see this folder, and you can see this folder, and upload the PowerPoint slides from there. So if you have a, if you some of people, if you don't understand, then I'm going to share my desktop. So hopefully you can see this. So this is my laptop, this is my desktop, and for example, it is my this is your class. Just go to your class, and here you will see this. This is a folder. This folder is called a extra resources folder. This folder I create with myself, and when you click this folder, you found there are the three subfolders are there. The one for this one, in this folder you found the PowerPoint slides. I upload this PowerPoint slide here. You can download this PowerPoint slides from here. The same PowerPoint slide that I teach you right now, you can download this PowerPoint slide from here. After that, there are two some more. This is the assignment folder. This it is empty right now. I will upload the assignment after the third week. And the third folder is solution of even questions. There are the solutions of even questions. Yani when you read the book, there are several questions are there in the book. Even and odd questions are 1, 2, 3, 4. So the solution only the even questions are there. You can download this slide, this also, and just try to solve the questions out there. So hopefully you understand. So if you have any other queries, then you can ask me. Okay, I will see if it is possible. Then I will try to upload before face to face. Let us try. I'm not sure that I will try my best because if I have to create these slides before, so I will try my best if it is possible. So okay, have a nice day and a good night.
تم إيقاف التسجيل.